Hey, thanks again for joining me for our daily devotion. It's Friday as we wrap up our week here at Desert Foothills and wherever you are at. Again, hope to be able to see you on Sunday for worship as we continue our series in the book of Ephesians. Today, I wanted to look back again on some of our readings from Sunday. On Sunday, we got to discuss that epistle text from the book of Ephesians. On Tuesday's daily devotion, I went over the gospel lesson just briefly. And so today I thought we could hit the Old Testament lesson from Sunday that we didn't have an opportunity to get to either. It comes from the book of Amos, chapter 7. And today we're just going to look at verses 7 and 8. It says, "This is what he showed me," talking about God. Amos is speaking about him. "This is what he showed me. The Lord was standing by a wall that had been built true to plumb, with a plumb line in his hand. And the Lord asked me, 'What do you see, Amos?' 'A plumb line,' I replied. Then the Lord said, 'Look, I am setting a plumb line among my people Israel. I will spare them no longer.'" So just before this small piece of the text happens, Amos is speaking to God and pleading with him on behalf of the people. They have sinned horribly against God. God is actually preparing to be able to punish them, and Amos speaks up on their behalf, and the Lord pauses his punishment and says something very interesting. He actually asks Amos a question. He says, "What do you see here in my hand, Amos?" And Amos says, "A plumb line." Do you know what a plumb line is? Today I thought I could just show you real quick if you don't have any idea. It's something that's typically used in construction. Many times you would see it when you were building maybe like a cinder block wall here in the state of Arizona. So basically you just take some type of a string and a weight, and you hang the weight, just tie it to the bottom of the string, and you hang the line and you let it sit. And as the weight kind of takes a moment to be able to be pulled by gravity, and the string straightens out, you get this perfectly straight line. And from there, you can line up, would it be cinder block or whether it be tile, perfectly straight, because gravity does its thing and it gives us this standard to be able to build by. So today in the text, God tells Amos exactly that. He says, "Do you see what's in my hand?" He says, "I am laying down a plumb line, a standard for the people to be able to live off of and to be able to build their lives upon." And I thought that was so neat. God using something, again, physical, something that Amos can see to be able to show us in our lives what we can be able to build by. So what is the plumb line that you typically use to be able to construct your day or your life around? Maybe for some of us, we use a plumb line of success. Maybe we want to continue to build our life off having some type of success. Maybe for some of us, it's, I don't know, maybe it's a financial gain that we're looking at. For many of us, no matter what we're building our lives off of, I think we could probably look at it and say, well, there's a lot of selfish things that I line up to be that plumb line in my life. I don't always use the plumb line that God has given to me. But isn't that something amazing that the Lord pauses this time within the life of his people, not to punish them, but to lay down this ground for them to be able to have success, not based upon their own personal gain, but based upon what God has given to them. He does the same not just for Amos and the people that he speaks to in that Old Testament text, but he does so for you and me, the church of today. That he gives us this great line to be able to guide everything off of. In fact, we hear about that line later on in Scripture, and even earlier on in Scripture, even in the book of Isaiah, of this line, this lineage that will be produced and show us who Christ is and our Savior to be able to build our lives upon. So this week, and moving forward into the weekend, in the days and months that are ahead, when you're making those little decisions in life or those big decisions in life, think about what line you are basing them off of. Is it a line of selfishness or a line of your Savior? Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for just coming to us as a people and always being patient with us, of always being loving, and of taking time to be able to give us guidance and be able to just give us something to be able to build upon so that we find success, Lord, in you. Again, just be with each and every one of us today, Lord, as we need your guidance and we need your strength more than ever. And so continue to be able to chaperone us ahead as we are a group of people who build our lives upon you and upon your work. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Again, blessings on your day. Hope you like that little visual aid today. Maybe it's something you can share with a friend. Maybe it's something new you learned. But for all of us, something that we can build our lives upon. Have a great weekend.